Angelica, isn't Mrs. May right to be worried about the Brexiteers in this sense, that the course of Brexit has been of successive concession, and Mrs. May's direction of travel seems to be towards a much softer Brexit, something which you might like, rather than the sort of Brexit which the Brexiteers want?
Well, look, a softer Brexit would be in this country's economic interest, but what we saw today was the extreme Eurosceptics in the Conservative Party, 62 of them, demanding a hard Brexit with menaces. Obviously, there are 62, that's 20 more than they need to trigger a leadership election. They asked for a range of things that are actually impossible to deliver, including WTO rules, including ensuring that if we come out of the European Union, we cannot have any connection to the single market or the economic area. It would be a disaster for the country. So she was being basically told that if she didn't deliver the impossible, a new trade deal in an impossible amount of time, if she didn't do as she was told, which would equal a hard border in Northern Ireland, then they have the power to trigger a leadership election, and that's what was going on in this letter.
And yet you might say exactly the same thing is going on in the Labour Party, where there are around 60 or so backbenchers trying to put the squeeze on Jeremy Corbyn to support either staying in the single market or staying in the customs union. Just as a point of public information, what is Jeremy Corbyn's position?
Well, look, I mean, Emily Thornberry said that we'd need to be in a customs union. We've said we want a jobs-friendly Brexit.
So is that the position? You want to be in a customs union after the transition phase?
That is the position. But we want a jobs-friendly Brexit. What we don't want is a hard Brexit, which implies a hard border in Northern Ireland, which cuts us off from our trading partners who currently supply us with over 52% of our foreign trade. That would be a disaster for my constituents in Wallasey, for the automotive industry just up the road in Ellesmere Port, and it would cause a huge dip in our economic prospects. That is not in the interest of the country, and what we see is a Prime Minister putting her party interest and her own survival ahead of the national interest, and that is shameful.
Okay, Tom-